Must be too early to wake up. I didn't hear a cock-a-doodle-doo. No, it's not too early. That's the sun. It's past time to wake up. Why didn't Rooster crow? Nobody's awake yet. I better go see if Rooster is all right. Rooster, are you all right?
No, I've got a touch of the cock-a-doodle flu. I can't crow. It's terrible.
Oh, no. Is there anything I can do for you?
You can wake everyone up.
Me?
Sure. There's nothing to it. And it would really help me out.
Okay, Rooster. You just get well and leave the waking up to me.
Thanks, Slim. And listen, everyone has to be up before the sun gets over the apple tree. Or else they'll miss the morning.
Miss the morning? Don't worry. I won't let anyone miss the morning. So how do I wake everyone up? Rooster? I guess I'll just have to figure it out for myself. So how does Rooster do it? He usually stands up here and yells, cock-a-doodle-doo. Cock-a-doodle-doo! I'd better try again. Cock-a-doodle-doo! That still wasn't loud enough. I better go see if Mouse and Dog can help. Dog! Little Chick! Mouse, wake up!
Go back to bed, Slim. It's not time to wake up yet. We haven't heard Rooster.
And you won't, Mouse. Rooster's sick. He's got the cock-a-doodle flu. He asked me to wake everyone up, so I cock-a-doodle-dooed, but...
You did? I didn't hear you.
That's the problem. I wasn't loud enough.
I bet I can wake everyone up. Listen to this. Funny, it worked the other night.
Hey, look, it woke Duck up.
Oh, Mallet, is it that late already?
It is that late, Duck. And pretty soon the sun will be over the apple tree.
Over the apple tree? I almost missed the morning. What happened to Rooster?
Rooster's got the cock-a-doodle flu. So we have to wake everyone up.
Let's go up to Rooster's place, and Dog can make his noise from up there. That should do it.
Good idea, but we better start, because we've got to hurry. It's the morning, and tomorrow we'll soon be knocking at your door.
Come on, everyone. We've got no time to lose.
Here we are, Slim. Go ahead, Dog.
Okay, but my howl is even louder than my bark. Is everybody ready? Ow!
Wasn't loud enough either.
I can't howl or cock-a-doodle-doo or anything, but I can squeak pretty loudly.
Great, Mouse, go for it.
Okay, but you better cover your ears. My squeak has been known to break glass in the next county. Squeak!
It didn't work. So I'm not loud enough. Dog isn't loud enough. And Mouse isn't loud enough.
But don't you worry, Slim, because he who quacks last, quacks the loudest.
Make it good, Duck.
You're a last chance.
Quack!
Oof! Oh, wow!
That was great, Duck.
But it didn't work.
And don't forget, miss the morning, and tomorrow we'll soon be knocking on your door.
What are we going to do?
We've got to think of something! Hey, you guys. Not so loud. I'm trying to sleep.
Sorry, Squirrel, but we're just... Wait a minute. That's it. When you guys made a noise together, you woke up Squirrel. So maybe if we all make our noises together, then we'll be loud enough to wake up everybody. noises all together at the same time.
Ruff, ruff.
And we gotta wake everyone up this time. Because look, the sun is almost over the apple tree.
This noise has got to be as loud as possible.
If you need a louder tone, try a megaphone.
What's a megaphone?
A megaphone is like the big end of a horn. It makes sounds louder. Where are we ever going to get a megaphone?
Hey, Mouse, I can be a megaphone. Quick, let's make our sound into me.
Slim, you never cease to amaze me.
Okay, everyone, all together now. One, two, three.
Together, we'd be loud enough to wake everyone up. And it worked. Good night, Mama.
Good night, Slim.
Oh, good night, Slim.
Good night, Slim.
Ah! Attention, everyone! This is just a test. Do not wake up.
Very thin pig, he's a skinny, smart piggy, he's out of sight.